to my channel. I am from School Lumi. In today's video, I'm going to be organizing my perler beads. I asked on a poll earlier today if y'all want me to do perler beads on my channel, because I didn't know if y'all wanted me to. And y'all said yes. So, that's what I'm doing today. I do have a case that is my first ever case of perler beads. I don't know if y'all can see that, but this is my first ever perler bead case. It has white... Wait, actually, I'm just going to wait until I'm done organizing all of these. This is not the one I'm going to be organizing today. Once I'm done with that, if y'all want me to do that. If I use... If I use all of those up, and if y'all want me to do a storage tour of perler beads, or if y'all want me to do a... organizing that one as well, please let me know. But today is going... I can't really fit this all on camera. But today it's going to be this storage case. I had this a few years. It was rainbow loom. But since I'm going back to perler beads, and I have a better case for rainbow loom, and other cases for rainbow loom, then I'm going to use this sucker right here. But on top of it has some bands in it, like unofficial bands. So I have to use those up before I open the empty bag up. But let's first, I'm going to time-lapse this, so it won't be that long, because I thought time-lapse would be pretty cool. But first up is this little storage case right here. There's three slots. There's this mini one on top, and then there's two medium big size ones. So in here is going to be all my tools. I don't have a lot of them, but like, it's going to be like mini... like small colors, and then my tools are gonna be over here or over here. But I'll show you guys my tools real quick. Like I said, I don't have a lot of tools of perler beads yet. I'm still learning, but once I do get better at it, then that will be it. And I might also put my pegboards in there, like my mini pegboards, but I don't think it will fit. So this is kind of like the only tool I have right now, but it's a little scooper, and then a little bigger thingy, I don't know what it's called, but I'm going, I'm going to set it right sideways right here. I think that'd be the only way it fits. Yes, I was right. Okay. I don't know if I have any other tools that I need for that little small little thing. Sorry, that was a pegboard. That makes sense. I also have a big box of it. Of perler beads. That I kept. But, I do have this. This came with a perler bead, I think. I don't know if anyone's seen this, but it's the way you make bracelets. So I'm just gonna set that right here, just in case if I ever wanna do anything with bracelets. But I think that's all gonna be in here. I might put some beads in here, just like little beads that I don't have a lot of, but other than that, this is my tool section. Okay, so next is this little thing. It does still have some rainbow loom stuff in here, like a pin, broken pin bar, C-clips, all that jazz. But this is going to be probably my main colors, like black and white, beige, browns, name it, you name it, reds, probably, I don't know, but this is going to be like my main colors. So let me show you all the main colors I have over here. Red's already open, so I might just put red in here, so I this, and I'm just gonna put these in here, and then I need to get my whites, brown, black, grays, more black. I don't know if all of this will fit in that those spots, but I'm just gonna show you all the main colors that I have, or that I use. Because I like making big projects. I don't like making the small ones. I don't know. It's just like, I don't know what it is, but I don't like it. But, big projects is just very relaxing. So I do have this open type of red with a little white in there. I don't know how that got in there. And then I have black, brown cocoa, brown beads. Put these over here. I have the rest of my white. I have like this light gray kind of beige kind of color. I haven't used those yet. And then I have an open pack of red. And then I have some dark gray beads. Oh dang, I have another pack of black. It's because I was making a ninja turtle that one time. I'll show that in another video. And then my other main color are these three, which is tan beads. I use an Elsa on this. So I had to get three more packs left. And then I also have like a big bucket of beads. I don't know what that is. But it's like a big bucket that you get when you're a beginner. Or that I get when I'm a beginner. But, yeah. So, I also have other colors, but that's going to be another time lapse. So, this is going to be the first case I'm going to do on time lapse. So, I'll be back when I'm done. Another like me. So I have just organized my main colors that I use all the time. So that's in there. I'm not gonna tell you what, I already told you what colors they are, but like, I'm just gonna do a storage video and another video for next weekend. So stay tuned for that. But now, I am going to organize my other colors, yay. So that would be red, orange. I'm gonna do it in rainbow. But I have all my reds and oranges and yellows. I don't know, we'll see. But red's gonna be that big spot because I use red a lot. So yeah. So I'm gonna time lapse and ignore these bands right here. I'm gonna time lapse and I'll be back. Hey guys, so after a lot of organizing, I still have some colors left, but these are all my main colors I'm using right now because I am working on a TMNT mule. Sorry about that, guys. But I'm working on a TMNT mule right now, and I'm really excited about how it's going to turn out. So, once I iron something else, then I'll be working on that. But, Yeah, so these are all my colors. Let me just close it up if I can. There we go. These are all my colors. I'm not going to show you guys full detail because I want to save that for another video. But I'll just show you what's like the top of it. So this is the tools. This is my main skin tone case. And then, sorry for the alarm. This is bay colors that I like to use all the time. And then the top is going to be my extra bands. Extra beads. I had to throw this away. But, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any more video suggestions for pillow beads, leave them on my Instagram, recent Instagram picture, and that'll be down below. For projects, finished projects, it'll be on my Instagram spam account, so stay tuned for that. But without any further ado, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please know I'm not trying to beg any way, shape, or form. And I will see you guys all later. Bye guys, sorry if this is a 29 minute long video, I'm just guessing, but if I'm right, then give this a big thumbs up. But anyways, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell for the next time I post a video, and I'll see you guys all later. Bye guys, have a good weekend.